Stay here, Jeffy. Stay here, there's coyotes. You heard me. Don't bring any snakes in. No snakes. Leave the lizards alone. So they allow you to dump your tanks, get free water, it's got cheap propane, and then I have to get gas in the RV, and pick up a prescription at CVS, and it's right next to McDonald's, so I'm going to see if I can't hijack their Wi-Fi to download a video, because I've been trying, and there's just not enough strength in my Wi-Fi out here to get a video posted, so see what I can do. People. That's what the cops were knocking up my door. I got my tanks filled and errands run, and now I'm on my way to Joe Skeen's campground in Grants, New Mexico, and just had to film the approach to Flagstaff. Isn't it gorgeous?
This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. As I was walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me that endless skyway. I saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me. I've roamed and rambled, and I followed my footsteps to the sparkling sands of her diamond deserts. And all around me, a voice was sounding. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. When the sun came shining and I was strolling, and the wheat fields waving and the dust clouds rolling, and the fog was lifting, a voice was chanting. This land was made for you and me. As I went walking, I saw a sign there, and on the sign it said no trespassing, but on the other side it didn't say nothing. That outside was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. In the shadow of the steeple, I saw my people. By the relief office, I've seen my people. As they stood there hungry, I stood there asking, is this land made for you and me? Nobody living can ever stop me as I go walking that freedom highway. Nobody This land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. This land was made for you and me.
Well, it's a beautiful day here in Grants, New Mexico at Joe Skeen's campground. I came in last night about supper time and it was full. And a camper in a van and with tents let me kind of slide in the edge of theirs. So when I got up this morning, I hiked up to the top. I was at the entrance, basically, of the loop. So I hiked up to the top with Pepper. And I had no cell service at that other spot. So when I got up here to the top, I saw someone had left. And I have good cell service. So I was only going to stay a couple days. And it takes me, I want to stay almost a week at places because it takes a lot out of me physically to, you know, all the work associated with RVing, filling up your tanks and all those things. I just need to relax for a few days. And the animals don't travel well either. They hate it. So now that I have a good spot, I will be here for a while. And it's so nice up here. Every campsite has a, let me see if I can get it in there. You see that little pavilion with picnic tables? Every campsite has that. But unfortunately, there's only about 10 or maybe a couple extra. So I got up here and I got my solar set up and I'll show you the views around here. It's just one loop, basically. So I'm at the top here and if you walk over, there's all sorts of little trails around here. It's really nice. I mean, I can't believe this is a free campground. Unfortunately, there's no water, no electric, there is vault toilets, and there's trash bins, but there's a sign on them. I don't think you're supposed to use them. I don't know. I don't know what they're for if we can't put our trash. They need to figure that out so that people don't dump their trash on the ground. If they could just put dumpsters every so often around these places, you know, it would save the environment from trash. So look at this. This is right outside my campsite. It's a ledge. See the ledge? Goes straight down. So I guess I don't have to worry about coyotes coming from this direction. And that's the road I came in on. And the entrance is just right down there a little ways, and it's not far to get up here to the loop. It's Highway 117. I think I got off. I forget if I did. I was on Highway 40. I can't remember if 117 was immediately off 40 or if I had to take another road, but this was pretty easy to find because when you get on 117, there's a sign that points for, I forget what it's called, but the sign points this way. So you know if you go this way, you're going to run into Joe Skeen. And there's a sign if you're watching on the left to find Joe Skeen's. Who is that rubbing my leg? You're gonna fall off this cliff, Miss Daisy May. Come on, come up here. So I have a nice little camp spot. I'm just excited and I have good cell service. I was able to post my video this morning that I've been trying to do for days since I left. Cause I left, what, 11 days ago, 10 days ago? Been working on video, but I just didn't have the cell service strong enough. There's a vault toilet right there. I don't know if I'll use it or not. My black tank is good for a couple months, so I'll be in Indiana and I can dump it at the fairgrounds. Got my solar set up. And this road's just a loop. Isn't that beautiful? This is nice. I didn't think anything could surpass Cottonwood where I just came from, but this is pretty nice too. Unfortunately, the sunset won't be on those rocks like I had the good sunset. The sunset shines over there. But this is the loop. We got some campers I can see that are here for just more than one day. He's got a little arthritis going on. So here's my camping buddy. What's your name again?
TK.
TK and
David 380 Shooty. 20 degrees more than a full circle.
You'll have to hear the story someday.
And David, right?
Yeah, David.
David has hip issues like I do. Is it your right or left?
My right.
It's my left. So we make a match pair. You gonna show me this RV?
Yeah.
This is a new Jayco.
Integra. 30 foot.
Integra. What's this, like a little bar or TV out here?
It's a TV in the stereo.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
All right.
You the handles.
Come on, Pepper, over here.
Stay here, Pepper. Or if he goes back... He'll be alright. Oh wow, it's nice and new, uncluttered like mine. Oh, you even got the table with your 30-footer.
Yeah,
see, I didn't. They cut that out. Oh, you got a smaller kitchen than I do.
Yeah, this goes out into a bed right here.
Okay.
This drops down into a bed right here.
Oh really?
Yeah, this is a queen bed. This is where he sleeps. Okay.
Oh wow.
So this just comes. Yeah.
How cool is that?
Yeah, automatically in a queen.
Oh, bed. You don't have slides, do you?
Don't have what?
Slides.
Yeah, we're in slides right here.
Oh.
It slid out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're all slid.
Okay.
So you can look at the back master. Two wardrobe doors there and there. Yeah, and there's a bathroom.
Is that a bathtub?
Yeah, that's a shower. Yeah, shower.
Could you? You couldn't use it for a tub,
no,
could you?
Probably not.
See, I like my bath is open to my bedroom.
Right.
So it's, you know, and I have a little corner shower. And it's just, for a woman, it's nice.
This closes all the way off.
I think I have more closet space.
Do you think so?
Uh-huh.
Open up this wardrobe.
Yeah,
there's a...
Yeah.
Oh man, we had these cinnamon rolls, Hertz Donuts in Branson, Missouri. The cinnamon roll was that big. It was. It's so big it hurt you.
You don't have very many clothes. Mine are stuffed. I just think I need to get rid of some clothes. Yeah. I still have more clothes back in Indiana. Yeah.
And so this makes a bed too, right here. This drops down.
Oh, wow. You can get a lot in here.
Yeah, I get a lot. This has a TV that flips up here.
Can you tell me how much you paid for it?
I paid $129.
Oh my God. Mm-hmm.
So this comes up for this.
Yeah, my TV's hanging over my windshield.
Yeah, but there's no reception here, I'm sure, so we're not even going to try.
Well, I'm using my hotspot, and I'm watching.
You know how to plug in with
Fox News and.
With your phone?
Yeah.
Yeah, I need to know how to do that.
Hotspot on your phone.
And then just, Bluetooth it to there?
Yeah, Bluetooth. Make sure your Bluetooth is turned on to whoever you got your name under. And then flip your hotspot, and on your TV, go to settings, and you'll see your name, whatever your phone's under. Mine just says iPhone.
I can show you how to do it, Dave. But
all right.
So if you can, you got to have, you know, your at least light with two bars, or 5G with two bars.
Yeah, I would say at least 4G, if not
the 5G. It keeps going in and out, so that's a pain. But I have backup. I have videos, too.
And then these turn around, so you can sit this way.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they flip around.
See, I took my passenger seat out and put a kitty tower on them.
So much for somebody riding shotgun.
I know. I couldn't be in an RV with anybody. I'd have to be madly in love. Or I thought about bringing one of my kids with me, but I couldn't do it.
Yeah, you're pretty easy, but I see you do have your ways.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Hey, anybody at our age, my age.
Well, anyway. I know.
How old are you?
I'm 66 and a half.
Okay, I'm 72.
Yeah, I'm only
12. How old are you?
I'll be 13 next week.
You look like, let me guess, you look like you're about 57.
Thank you. I'm going to give you an extra martini tonight.
63?
61.
Okay, somewhere around there.
That's nice of you to say that.
So, yeah.
Oh, shit. That does hurt. Your
hip. Yeah,
it hurts. My hip hurts.
Hey, Dave, you see this? We're so high up.
Yeah,
how'd you do that?
So I got the skills.
My levelers.
He's got the levelers.
I broke my levelers, too.
Oh, did you?
I ran out of words. I'm a sloppy driver.
Uh-oh. You hitting stuff all the time?
I'm headed over to David's RV for a campfire. So let's go see what they're all about. I was going to take my guitar, but I only know 3 chords, maybe 4. So we'll see. They talked me into it. I'll come back and get it.
Oh, shit.
And Biden won't forgive it, right?
Yeah, fuck
all
him.
Right, now do your poem, David.
My love flows like rivers to the sea. It really makes me wonder why, like lightning cracks the sky. I always go with the flow. That's something I know you know. We'll just have to wait and see until one day my love is yours and yours is me. Dave Schutte.
Really nice. Who'd you write that for, David?
Which girlfriend was that? That could have been.
You were supposed to say you did it this afternoon just for me.
No, that was probably for Michelle.
Okay.
What? Duran.
And what happened to Michelle?
Oh, I messed up on that deal. Would you stop it? Put that.
You have a stargazer photographer.
So, have you met Candace here? I want you to meet Candace. She's definitely.
You got some fancy equipment.
Hey, Candace.
Hi.
This is Dawn. Okay?
I can't get into this. Are you doing that on purpose?
We're going to send it straight to his. Oh, yeah. Don't you have the red? See, normally we have red.
Well, there was no campfire. They were into some stargazing, so I thought I would come home and finish watching. You know what? I'm too old to sit around watching grown-ass men drink themselves silly. Past that. Way past that. They were nice, though. They were nice guys. Just like the party. I'm glad I came home. Because they started a fire and it's kind of a windy night. And before I left, I said, I don't think it's a good night. I'm drunk. I mean, there's a dry field right beyond them. Plus, I don't need my RV burning up. camper. Do you like this campsite? Do you like it as well as the other ones we've been to?
I like playing at the campsites, Mom. It's just I don't like traveling in the RV. And you know what? The cats don't either, and I know you care about that. Can we just stay here forever? Because this one's pretty special. And I'll be good to the kitties. I promise, Mom. I promise. And I won't beg for cookies anymore if you can just stay here.